Welcome back friends. In this video we'll talk about trivial and non-trivial dependencies, closure of a set of FDs and closure of a set of attributes. So already you know what table R is there, and the attribute sets are X and Y, and we can write X arrow Y. Okay, it is, so we can write X arrow Y. So X functionally determines Y. So X functionally, okay, so X functionally determines Y. That means if and only if each X value in R has associated with it precisely only one Y value in R. Okay, now we have a table, say name of the table says student, and the attributes are roll number, name, department ID and department name. Let roll number and department ID is a keys. So the functional dependency is what we can say, we can identify name using roll number. Roll number determines name and department ID. Okay, using roll number and name we can identify name. Using roll number and department ID we can identify department name, and from department ID you can identify department name, and so on. So these are the FDs already you know. So here roll number determines name. That means what? With a given roll number, value has the same name value. That means if you put once again another roll number 1, always should be the same N1 value, because name roll number determines name. Maybe the department is say X, say cultural department. Note that in a table R, A arrow B is there. That means A determines B, and A is not a candidate key. That is, FD is not trivial and A is not a super key, then R will involve some redundancy. Okay. Number 2, FD represents integrity constraint and DBMS thus needs to enforce it. Remember one thing, data depends on dependency. Dependency doesn't depend on data. Okay. And if A is distinct, let this is A, and if A is distinct, then blindly we can say suppose two attributes are there, A and B, and if A is distinct 1, 2, 3, then by blind you can say that A arrow B. That means A determines B. Okay, next we'll talk about trivial and non-trivial dependencies. Now practically we need to reduce the number of functional dependencies, and to reduce the size of the set of functional dependencies we need to deal with is to eliminate the trivial dependencies. And FD is trivial if and only if the right hand side is a subset of the left hand side. Okay, so functional dependencies are two types, say trivial and non-trivial. So trivial means what? So let X determines Y and Y is a subset of X, then it is a trivial. And non-trivial means what? X arrow Y and Y is not subset of X. If it is the case, then it is called non-trivial. Okay, so we can see one example. Suppose we have a table R. So what you can do, we can write functional dependency like this way. Say from roll number name, we can identify the roll number, and from roll number name, we can identify the name. Okay, similarly we can identify using roll number, we can identify name and marks. Now you can see this roll number, say this is Y, is a part of this X. This roll number is a part of this roll number, and this name is a part of this name. So that means these two are the example of trivial functional dependency. But in this case, say this is what Y, and this Y is the, and this is X, and this Y is not part of the X. So that means what? This functional dependency is what? It is non-trivial functional dependency. Okay, so the trivial dependencies are not very interesting in practice. We are usually more interested in practice in non-trivial dependencies. Okay, now next is closure of a set of FDs. Okay, so first of all, what is closure? First of all, we should know what is closure. So the set of all FDs that are implied by a given set S of FDs is called the closure of S and written in S plus. So that means what? We have a set of given S. Okay. We have a set of given FDs, say S, and it is given, and we apply some inference rule. Inference rule to get closure. Okay, closure of S. To get closure of S. And it is denoted as S plus. Okay, for example, we have it say three attributes A, B, and C, and the functional dependency A to A arrow B, B arrow C. Okay, these two are given. Now from this given, we can identify the closure like this way. So from A to A we can identify, okay, from B we can identify B, from A we can identify B, using B we can identify C, that means we can using A we can identify C, using A we can identify BC, and so on. Now how it is possible? So we should know the inference rule. So next we'll see different inference rule. Okay, now let A, B and C, let A, B and C be arbitrary subset of set of attributes. So these are the set of attributes of the given table R, of the given table R, okay, of the given table R, then the inference rules are, so the inference rules are as follows. The first rule is what? Reflexivity. So if B is a subset of A, then A arrow B, it is a definite, it is trivial dependency, already you know. Next is what? If A arrow B, then AC arrow BC, it is what? Augmentation. That means next is what? If A arrow B and B arrow C, then A arrow C, that is called transitivity. Okay, so that means what? If A arrow B and B arrow C, definitely from this we can identify A arrow C, transitivity. Now if A arrow A, that means it is called self-determination. Next rule is what? If A arrow B C, then A arrow B and A arrow C, this is called decomposition. Next, if A arrow B and A arrow C, then we can write A arrow B C, it is called union. Next, if A arrow B and C arrow D, then A C arrow B D, that is called composition. Next, if A arrow B and B C arrow D, then we can write A C arrow D, it is called pseudo transitivity. Finally, if A arrow B and C arrow D, then A union C minus B arrow B D. To get the closure of the FDs, we have to use these inference rules. Okay. Okay. Now see one example. Let the table name is R and the attributes are A, B, C, D, E, F. And the given attribute, the given FDs are E arrow B C, B arrow E, and C D arrow E F. That means what? E arrow B C, B arrow E, B arrow E, and C D arrow E F. It is given. Now, to identify the closure of FDs, we have to use this inference rule repeatedly. Okay, that means, for example, so this is what our S. Now, so this is what our S. Now, using this inference rule, we can identify the closure of there. That means S plus. Now, A to B C, like this one, A arrow B C, it is given. Okay, now that means what? We can identify A to A arrow B and A arrow C. That is called what it is called decomposition. We can apply decomposition. So here we can get using the decomposition. Similarly, here A arrow C, here if we add both sides, that means what? AD, we can get AD arrow CD. So we can say it is called augmentation. Okay. So here if you add C, you can get AC and BC augmentation. So if you add D, we can get AD arrow CD, and it is possible using the augmentation rule. Similarly, we can we can add D here, that means what? AD arrow BD, same augmentation. Are you getting? Now we have a CD arrow EF. We have a CD arrow EF, and already you know AD arrow CD. That means what? We can write what? AD arrow EF. It is called what? Transitivity. Now, if you see this one, we can write what? AD arrow E as well as what? AD arrow F. Okay, so it is called decomposition. We can use this one. So it is possible using decomposition. Are you getting this one? Okay, so here AD arrow EF and here AD arrow CD, that means we can write what? We can write AD arrow CDEF. Similarly, we can say B arrow E, it is there. Okay, B arrow E, it is there. So that means what? We can write BC arrow EC. Okay, and here it is no A arrow BC, that means what? We can write what? A arrow EC. So in this way, we can identify various functional dependency by applying inference rule and using this particular given FDs. So that is, we can compute closure. Closure is what? S plus. We can compute closure of a given set of S, of a given set of A's, of FDs, by means of an algorithm that says repeatedly apply the rules until they stop producing new FDs.